as if it couldn't have any more significance, you know, that this day is the birthday of Sri Chaitanya Saraswati Mat. So Guru Maharaj says, and on this day, in 1942, he'd been there for around a year, here, there, you know, he says, according to Guru Maharaj, on this day, the Rath Yatra day, 1942, I entered the hut and started Chaitanya Saraswati Mat, and he put up that big bamboo pole with the flag flying. So we try to mean that tradition here, like yesterday, Umadha Prabhu, we have to really thank you for that. He went and we changed the flag once a year. So he did it yesterday. So now the flag of Sri Chaitanya Saraswati Mat is flying. And so a little while back, because I am familiar with Guru Maharaj's talks, I assembled a little compilation called The Flag of Sri Chaitanya Saraswati Mat. But meaning, what does it represent? And I'm not going to read the whole thing. It's long. But this is an excerpt from it where the founder Acharya of Sri Chaitanya Saraswati Mat, namely Om Vishnupad, Srila Bhakti Rakak, Sridhar Dev Goswami Maharaj. I say here, describes his vision of the Mat he founded. Because sometimes we hear so many things. Then like we'll say, well, what does Guru Maharaj say the Chaitanya Saraswati Mat is? Right? As I said, that Krishna should be accepted when he says certain things. Like everything. Then Guru Maharaj, if he's telling you what Chaitanya Saraswati Mat is, you can understand that that's what it is or what it aspires to be. He's the person who said an institution is founded to promote an ideal. You make an organization or an institution to promote an ideal. So according to him, what is the ideal upon which Sri Chaitanya Saraswati Mat is founded? So I refer to the Mat Pranam as the conceptual architecture of the Mat. And in there, it's Srimat Chaitanya Saraswata Matabara Udgita Kirtir Jayasrim Bibrat Sambati Ganga Tata Nikata Navadvipa Kuladi Raje Yatra Sri Gaura Saraswata Nirata Gorata Grananti Nityam Rupa Nuga Sri Kritimati Guru Gauranga Radha Jitasa. Then Srila Guru Maharaj, he says, please cooperate. All right, here we go. The flag of Sri Chaitanya Saraswati Mat flutters high, high in the over sky. That's poetic. He means outer space. That's how high it goes, into outer space. In Navadvip, on the banks of the Ganga, Chaitanya, where did I get that name? From Chaitanya Mat of Gaudi Mat. And Saraswata, from Saraswati, our Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. So Chaitanya Saraswata. The knowledge that has come from Chaitanya Dev up to Saraswati, our Guru Maharaj. Propaganda within that era, we are to revere, accept, and preach the angle of vision of our Guru Maharaj, Saraswati Thakur, about Sri Chaitanya Dev, how Srila Saraswati Thakur has seen with his divine eyes. That is what is available here. We are concerned with that. From Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to Saraswati, our Guru Maharaj, this is the Guru Parampara. The whole is covered, considered, cultured, and being preached or spread. That is Chaitanya Saraswat. Hare Krishna. Chaitanyanuga Saraswati. Another meaning of Saraswati means vani, vakya, words, expressions of Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya vani, the real preaching, instructions of Sri Chaitanya Dev, his words. That may be the meaning here. Chaitanya Vani, really from Chaitanya to Saraswati, the culture of Bhagavatam as viewed by Sri Chaitanya Dev and his followers up to Saraswati. That is our object. That is the theme of our life. That is the purpose of our life. Our parichoy, our identification, nature, acquaintance is there. Who are we? No, when he says it, he means, who are we? Those who say they're members of Sri Chaitanya Saraswat Math. That's what he's talking about. Who are we? We are so and so. They are our masters. We are the servants of that group. We want to revere them, to propagate them, to ask people to accept them. Our whole concern is there. Chaitanya, Saraswat, Saraswat, Chaitanya. And as usual, you know, Gaur Haribol, Gaur Haribol, Gaur Haribol. What distinguishes Chaitanya Saraswat? How it is modified by Chaitanya Dev, the line of Bhagavatam, what he has spread. Amongst all the acharyas, Sri Chaitanya Dev preached about love divine, clearly and in a developed way, in a scientific way. Only Sri Chaitanya Dev preached the fifth end of life, Bhagwat Prem. The end of life is to acquire love, affection, attraction for God or Godhead, for Krishna. Krishna is the Lord of love, and he is the innermost conception of Godhead. The highest conception of Godhead is Krishna, and Jiva can have relation with him, that of love, and that is the highest achievement of all souls ever known come to the world. So, Chaitanya Saraswata, not other Saraswata, Chaitanya Nuga Saraswata, followers that belong to the school of Sri Krishna Chaitanya, who believes in Krishna and the consciousness of Krishna, the believers of Krishna consciousness. The flag fluttering high over the sky means to have control over the whole globe. So it flutters high to control Udgita Kirtir Jayasrim, Bibrat, singing the glory, and it's capturing the whole world by Sri Chaitanya thought. And what is that? Rupanuga Sri. Their object is to enter into that loving service which is directed by Sri Rupa in the camp of Srimati Radharani, Radha Dasyam. That is the wealth of their heart. That is their aim. And they are following the method of Sri Chaitanya. And their flag is flying high over in the sky on the banks of the Ganga and Govardhan. Go up to Govardhan. That is what is shown in this sloka, the Mat sloka of Sri Chaitanya, Mat Pranam of Sri Chaitanya Saraswat Mat. When I was establishing this mat, there was only a thatched cottage, and I, myself, was cleansing the clay and dirt with my own hand. At that time, this was composed, came through me. I had some inner thought that Mahaprabhu is accepting my service from such a lower level, cleansing the clay and the earth, all these things. But there is some future grant. It portends some future resourcefulness. This place will be of high order. He is accepting service from my own hand. That was my feeling at the time. I composed that. Somehow it came. And one very tall bamboo was put there, its flag fluttering above. And that gave some inspiration to me. Udgita Kirtir, its glory is sung high in the sky. Jayasrim Bibrat, and it is holding the victorious color with it. Jayasrim Bibrat, the victorious resources, floated by this fluttering of the flag, which is so high, posted in the oversky and outer space on the banks of the Ganga and Navadvip, that it may have such potentiality. And I've inserted here to remind, Urjeshwari is the name of Radharani Jayasri. Urja means resources. She commands all the resources, the Shakti, the power, all the resources culminate in her. Then Ganga Tata Nikata Navadvipa Koladri Raje. Location of the place is Govardhan. Koladvip, Koladri Raje, king of mountains. Kola, Koladri, mountain on the banks of the Ganga. It is glittering there. And what is the function there? Yatra Sri Gaura Saraswata Mata Nirata. Who are really followers? Gaura Saraswati. From Sri Gauranga to Saraswati has come that flow. They have got faith in that. Gauragata Grananti, singing the glories of Sri Gauranga to the world. Those that are devoted in the cultivation of the grace of Gauranga, Gaura Saraswata, from Gauranga that came through, interpreted by Saraswati, our Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Gaura Saraswata, who engages himself fully in that opinion, that idea, and that thought. Matta Nirata Gauragata Grananti, and that quality of glorification of Sri Gauranga, that flow of Gaurakatha, they are singing here. And what is their object, the aim of their life? Srimad Rupanuga Sri Kritimati, Rupanuga Bhajan, Madhura Rasa, Radha Anugata, Krishna Bhajan, that is their aim. With that intention, they're singing the Sankirtan of Sri Gauranga. And their aim is there. Nityam Rupanuga Sri Kritimati Guru Gauranga Radha Jitasa. Their only hope is that one day they will be able to reach the destination. They will be able to serve Sri Radha and her beloved. That is their aim. And Gaura Sankirtan, their object is to attain their highest position in the Rupanuga service in the camp of Srimati Radharani. Their mentality is there and their activity is here. In a very dignified way, the flag is fluttering there, high up in the sky, from the Ganga on the summit of Govardhan Giriraj. And it was then only in a college I wrote this, 42 or so, and now it is 1983, he says. 40 years ago, that came through my pen, then turning to all of us. So your aim at present, that this will be here, and you will try to distribute this Gauravani from here to the world. That is the divine arrangement, and I keep it on my head. Activity under the guidance of Sri Gauranga, and our object is the camp of Radharani, Radha Govinda's service, guided by Srila Rupa Goswami, the line of Sri Rupa. Who are we? From Chaitanya Dev to Saraswati Goswami. That flow of instruction is our base, and our stay is in Govardhan, the Aparad Bhanjaner Pat. That was the idea. It came from the inner compartment of my heart, and I produced it in that way. My hope, some mystic hope, or ambition, whatever you might say, that mystic something made me write this. So who made me write this? And who supplied this thought in Bhaktivinoda Thakur, his prophecy, that will guide you. And then he, this is the last part. And he says, it may not come by the lips to the ear, but heart transaction. Tene Brahma Hridaya Adikavaye, transmission from heart to heart, Brahma to Krishna, gave this first knowledge to Brahma, the creator, through the heart. Then Brahma Veda was given to Brahma, creator of the world, through the heart, inspiration, not coming from the lip to the ear. Bhagavatam says, this transmission, this transaction, this flow of heart, heart to heart. Otherwise, the ears cannot catch and the lips cannot produce. That's what Srila Gurumar said about his Sri Chaitanya Saraswat Math, which he founded on this Rath Yatra day, and the Aparad Bhanjan Arapat, and Sri Gupta Govardhan in Navadeep Dham in 1942. Hare Krishna.